What's up, guys? This is HotDiet7RCT bringing you another video for you guys. This time around, we're going to be covering Slain Back from Hell.
Yeah.
Heavy metal music, gore, blood, 16-bit gameplay, a la SNES, all meld together to form this amazing indie title that I don't know how it went under my radar completely in 2016, or I should think it came around 2016, because this is the first time me coming in contact with this game. I saw it and it's like, this is one of the hundreds, if not thousands, of games that just fly under the radar undetected, at least in my case, where I have so much going on at work that I really don't have that much time to play or research or do a lot of stuff. So I have to use my time and my resources the best that I can. That's life. But enough of that. The thing here is that this game is me. This game is me. It's right here. It has everything that I love, except maybe whiskey and sex, which is not included here, but everything else is basically right there. So, yeah. Look at that. I mean, that image right there says it all. You know, it's like, yeah. So, enough of the gushing. Let's go into the Switch menu here. And bring down the music and go right into nice little icon there. No fighting over the icons. Oh my god, just remembered reading about that. People up in arms about certain icons and stuff and fighting over that. Anyways, I'm not gonna say much about the game because I really don't know much about the game except the aesthetics, the music, and the gameplay. Background, I'll leave it up to you guys. All you gotta know is that this is on the eShop for the Switch. If you love heavy metal music, if you love 16-bit gameplay, go for this. It looks to be like a keeper. Ooh, listen to that. Listen to that. We're starting off well. Look at this. Now, there is a point where I get tired of seeing, because there's so many games now that uses the pixel art. And I would say that some people are abusing certain types just to make a quick buck, cash in the craze, in the retro craze. But this one feels different. This one has personality. This one feels like a gothic, well, not gothic, basically a a cross between Castlevania and Metalocalypse, or something heavy metal based. Something heavy metal based. It's incredible. It's just, I'm gonna go in. You even got the riffs when you move up, the guitar riffs. Okay, sound. I can't go to 11. Too bad. Controls. I'm not using the dog bone, I'm using the pro controller, but it's the same thing. Attack is Y, B is jump, change weapon with the right joystick or the D-pad. Block, mana spirit, dodge. Okay, I'll figure it out. Let's go into this. Oh man, I've got a feeling that this game is gonna kick my ass. Bathurin. Thank you. Look at that sword. Okay, so you have a power up attack. Look at that. Turns into a wolf. Is that a wolf? No, double jump. That's the only thing missing for it to be like the instant classic. It has a little floaty control to it. Let's see if it. Maybe it's just because I'm doing the capture card thing and maybe, I don't know. I'm not gonna read the story now, I just wanna see how this feels. Nice chunky sound to the swordplay. Look at that blood. So that's kind of like the save point when you charge. Whoa! Experience metal swordplay. Divine Angel. Love it. Ooh, that's magic. What the hell? No shit, I was slain. Those spikes came out of nowhere. Also, they don't fall into the trap. I do. What the fuck? What the hell? I'm just gonna try and jump. Just run past it. taking too long. Run over it. How the fuck am I supposed to pass that? The devastating attack. Look, this shit here, man. I really have no idea how to pass that. That looks nice. Still doesn't solve my issue here. Fucker. Doesn't have a double jump. The X doesn't block against it. I'm gonna try to block it, but somehow I doubt. Even blocking. I have no idea how to pass that shit. Thank you. God, I just had to jump it. Look at that crap. Medusa head. Yay! Generating motherfuckers? Get out of there. Ah! Trying to time the block, and I almost did it, but I got killed. So if you time the block well enough, it's gonna stun the enemy. Uh-oh, get out of there. It's a trap. Oh. Game just for the fact that it has that kind of old Mega Drive Genesis kind of difficulty feel to it. A little bit of the aesthetic too. Again? The fuck? Hurry up, hurry up! More Medusa heads. Oh shit! Get out of there! And another save point. Well, that's gonna be it, guys. I'm gonna keep it here. At least I... Yeah, that's checkpoint. This is where I'm gonna be leaving it. Great difficult play, 16-bit style, frustrating as hell, as you saw from me spending minutes just trying to figure out how to get around those trapping gates or whatever the hell they're called. I'm a little weirded out because I'm not hearing like the really heavy metal, you know, like the death metal, speed metal kind of thing going on, but maybe it changes depending on the level. All I know is that I'm very curious, I'm loving the gameplay, the control is tight. Just go pick up the game. The game is pretty cool. It's called Slain Back From Hell, and it's a really cool title to have. Just go ahead and pick it up. That's going to be it for this one. So remember, guys, to like and subscribe, and please share the videos. Most important to me, share it with other people. And let me know in the comment section if there's something else that you would like me to cover, showcase for you guys. This is Hot Diet 7 RCT signing out for now. Check you guys later. Take care. Peace.